starting your journey to financial freedom.
Now.
You're listening to the New Investor Podcast.
This is the Young Investor for the New Investor Podcast, and it is day 48 on our journey towards financial freedom. I wanted to spend some time today on how I will face the most recent news, being that President Trump will consider imposing additional tariffs on China, which also possibly means that we are nowhere close to a bilateral agreement between these two nations on that subject. So as a consequence, the Chinese markets opened at minus 4% and currently even hitting minus 6% at the moment I'm actually speaking to you. S&P 500 futures look like they will also open on a pretty substantial negative, close to 2%, and the Nasdaq 100 close to 2.25% negative. So these will definitely weigh on your gains so far for sure, but don't forget that we have been on a steady growth for a very long time and that the S&P 500 already hit an all-time high. So unless you're powered by insatiable greed, I am sure you'll be able to survive this news. How I see it, the important here is not to see to any panic and start a sell-off, as no investor cares about the day-to-day, only the macro matters evidently. In the previous episode, I did say that I had parked my cash in the S&P 500 as to benefit from any upsides. That was yesterday. That is going to be very short-lived, and I will be selling my position just because the objective of this operation at the time was essentially to park cash and not invest for the long term into the S&P 500. So I do not wish to lose too much cash, but I will unfortunately only after a day. So these are the rules of the game, no emotions here. When such a news occurs, I usually keep an eye on the companies I have placed on my watch list and hope they will hit the fair price I had in mind. If so, I will certainly start shopping around. Let's see on the open if this news triggers a good enough dip in the markets for me to start shopping. If not, then I will not and just wait until all of this passes. I have some forward planning ideas as well in terms of my next investments, but these can only be your own, as it is all up to your own best judgment based on your current level of awareness and knowledge in the sector and companies you are interested in. In those times, however, serious in their degrees, and when such a situation occurs on the news, I am sure you now realize the importance to always having cash on hand. Feeling like you are actually benefiting from markets' downsides and bad economic news means you are benefiting from all the possible dynamics of the market, may they be positive or negative. So it is a good feeling to have, and I believe that it is a very good way to go. So I was informed today, to my greatest surprise, that another bonus from a past property I was managing has been approved, which means I will be receiving additional funds that I did not forecast. Don't call it luck, as the fruits of your hard work are deserved to you, and only yourself knows the level of commitment you have deployed to increase your income through performance at your current job. We did speak about how to grow your income in the past episode. This is how it is done, and I am thrilled about it. Now, I'll be unfortunately investing only 50% of it, as life at times will bring essential expenses to your attention which you must commit to, and which I can now attend to earlier in my agenda, which is great. As you can see, regardless, I am still able to commit a percentage to investment. You should always commit a percentage to your future and to the future you, always, even if you have debt to clear. I read an article outlining that 42% of Americans have only $10,000 saved for their retirement. That basically means retiring poor, in stress, in need, and that is not America. I would do anything right now to have a chance to live and work in the United States. As seen from here, it is the land of opportunities without a doubt. 42% of Americans should be retiring with $1 million, and we are here to do exactly that. let's actually push this a little bit further. $1 million will be one of our milestones as we go along. To recap for today, 1. Don't panic. 2. Keep an eye on your watch list if you have cash on hand. 3. This is just one news and there is no reason to worry for the future of the US economy in 10, 20 or 30 years. 4. Only if, and it is a big if, companies hit the fair price you have determined to pay today, then go out there and start shopping. I will do nothing if this doesn't happen, but that's just me taking my own decisions based on my own best judgment. And finally, if you happen to have cash somewhere sitting, invest a percentage of it or park it into cash for the purpose of investment. Just a little news flash that was before the markets open, and I wish you a fantastic day ahead.
The podcast you just heard was made using Anchor. Ever thought about making your own podcast? Anchor makes it really easy for anyone to get started. It's a one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing podcasts. Best of all, it's 100% free. Sign up now at anchor.fm/new. That's anchor.fm/new to get started.